is island time. And when the tide is just right, we can step off the dock right onto our swim platform and walk up through this opening, and then we are right now in the cockpit. When you first walk in our main entrance, you are immediately in the salon area, which is almost like a great room, with it being connected with the kitchen. In boat terms, that's the galley. And there we have our, right is where actually I have my sewing machine set up, so I can do my sewing right there. Just turn that chair around and away I go. Scan back here. We got the actual television over there in the corner. It's nice. Built-in stereo system. We then go up these stairs, which takes us to the pilot house. And there's Ken. This is another great seating area. We actually have a breakfast. Does have windows all the way around. Most of them have curtains on them that I made last year. Last year we also made up these screens, and on this door they snap in. So we also have stairs that lead up to the flybridge, and again that's another door that we use for air ventilation. This screening that I made for this door, so keeps out those mosquitoes. This is the pilot house still. What do you want to say about the controls?
Replaced the older GPS with a new one here, Garmin. That's the old Raytheon radar, which is no longer used. It's obsolete. The new Garmin puts the radar right on top of the GPS map on the screen, so you don't need a separate radar. It also has a sonar depth finder. And
what's the screen to the left?
That's a TV camera that shows the engine room. Right now there's no lights on in the engine room. Below here is the autopilot. You can set a compass heading and it'll keep the boat just heading straight in that direction. This is the old Raytheon depth sonar, so I kept that. I actually have redundant sonar. The new one with Garmin and the old one is still working with Raytheon. These are your engine throttle controls here, which we're in the process of replacing. They're 20 years old and starting to become unreliable. So
so we have two engines.
Two engines, yep. Port and starboard engines. And then these are the readouts for the different engine attributes, the RPMs, you know, fuel level, temperature, oil pressure, that kind of stuff. The old Raytheon radio doesn't work anymore. We got a new handheld VHF radio. So you can see I'm slowly replacing all the original controls with new. Being 20 years old, they all need updating and modernization.
There we go.
Got the map up there. You can see the depth, 15 feet here in the channel. It's quite deep. And there's the chart.
So this is the stairway leading down into the lower portion of the boat, where all the bedrooms are. And just to show, it's kind of hard to get it all in the viewfinder. This is the master stateroom, and you can see the lots of built-ins. So we have a built-in dresser here. That's the sliding door. And then just off of that sliding door is our closet, which we actually have quite a bit of space in. And it is cedar. Actually get a lot of storage with that. And it doesn't really take up any space in the bedroom. Two doors is actually our laundry room. All right, so these doors open up, fold in half, and then push back into the side. Same here. Fold in half. And then push back. And then we have our washing machine and dryer. So yay, divides the shower and the toilet area. So you can see there would be where the shower is. Then this is where the head is, with a porthole conveniently located above the toilet. So it's a good little room. Then on this side, we have the shower and tub area. And actually, it's actually a fairly good sized tub. And then we have this little area right here for some little tchotchkes. And then moving here, this is the bunk room. We very, very rarely have guests that we need to have this room for. So we actually use this room for storage, and we really need it. We have guitar cases and sewing stuff and a closet in it. Pretty much just enough room to sleep in. And it does have a drawer below the bed and a little cabinet off to the side. It is the main head, or the guest head. There is the vanity area, and then of course the toilet. It's kind of like one of your standard, like an RV toilet. It has the vacuum pump. And then the shower. And from this bathroom, there's also a door going into the guest bedroom. We won't go through that way, though. We'll just go ahead and continue down the hallway here. And then this is the guest bedroom. And this is right in the bow of the boat. So that the corners are kind of all knocked off. Now the bed does have, it's on a pretty high base. And kind of was steps are on either side. And then this bedroom has a little TV and then some closet. And this is the door that's the door that leads to the bathroom. And then just can see the staircase that goes back up.